The Talking Skull by Chetter M. Galloway. You never ever know anyone that talks and talks and talks and talks. You know, they talk about things they know. They talk about things they don't know. They talk about things they think they know. They even talk about things they think you ought to know, even though you know they don't know a thing in the world about what they're talking about. You know what I mean? They just talk all the time. Well, such was the case of Juba, the djembe player. Juba was not only a master djembe drummer, but he talked all the time. He also spread vicious rumors, gossip, and called people out of their name. Well, one day, his best friend decided to teach Juba a lesson. She went out and gathered all the feathers she could find from every species of bird and put them in two huge sacks. She called Juba over to her hut and says, "I want you to get rid of these feathers in any manner you see fit." "You want me to do what?" he says. "Why, I am a master drummer, a djembe player. Any idiot could do this exercise. Why are you asking me?" She says, "Well, you should have no problem then." So he took the bags of feathers and went out and spread them up high, spread them down low, spread them out far and all places wide until the bags were empty. And he brought them back to his best friend and says, "You see, I told you it was an easy test. Anyone could have done it." Well, she says, "That's only part of your test. Now I want you to go back and retrieve all of those feathers." "You want me to do what? Do you not know where I put them? I threw them up high. I threw them down low, out far and all places wide. Why, it's impossible to retrieve all of those feathers. No one could do that. This is not a fair test." "Indeed," says his best friend, "for it's like those things you say, those lies, those rumors, calling people out of their name. Once they leave your mouth, they're like a feather in the wind. Oh, no matter how hard you try to retrieve them, they're gone forever." And Juba says, "Ah, I understand." Now, my friends, just because someone says they understand does not mean they will do the right thing. And very soon after that, Juba would be taught a much harsher lesson. For one day, as he was practicing his djembe drum beside the upside down tree, also known as the baobab tree, he would be taught this lesson. For Juba had been practicing all day, and around dusk he began to get thirsty and went to the water to fetch himself something to drink. But when he returned, there was something between his drum and the tree. And that something, my friends, was a skull. Well, unwisely, Juba leaned down, picked it up, and that skull did the unthinkable, the unspeakable. Why, that skull opened its mouth and spoke the following words: "My mouth brought me here, and your mouth will bring you here." Well, Juba took off running and tried to tell his friends, his family, what had happened, that he'd heard, he'd witnessed a talking skull. But no one would listen to him. So he went to the one place where he knew he would find a listening ear, and that was at the king's palace. Now, the king, my friends, was a giant of a man, standing nearly 7 feet tall. His hands, they say, could cover your entire face. But for all his physical stature, this soft-spoken, gentle giant was known for his patience and compassion and listening. So he allowed Juba to tell his story of the talking skull. And after Juba had finished, he said, "If what you say is not true, you shall regret it. Do you understand?" And Juba agreed. So Juba, the guard, and the king left the palace and left the village and went down that beaten path to find this alleged talking skull. And true to his word, There it was, between the djembe and the baobab tree, that upside-down tree. A tree that's so big and tall that it stretches up into the sky, reaches through the clouds, and ascends into the heavens where the stars roam. Juba says, there it is right there. There is the skull, just as I said it would be. Indeed, says the king. But let's see if it speaks as you say it can. So Juba once again leaned down, picked up the skull, and says, go ahead, speak as you did before. Tell them how you came to be here. But the skull didn't say anything. Oh, come now, don't be shy. Speak what you said before. Tell them how you came to be here. Again, the skull didn't say anything. Just one more time, sire, let me try, please. Tell them how you came to be here. Tell them what brought you here. Well, my friends, those were the last words ever heard from Juba. For upon orders from the king, he was chopped off at the head. And it said, doing, 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 doop, fell beside the skull. So the king and the guard left and went back to the palace. Well, Juba's head eventually became a skull. And it was at that time that that first skull, once again, opened its mouth and spoke these words. You see, Juba, I told you your mouth would bring you here, just like mine did me. So remember, don't say all you see. Don't tell all you know. The Talking Skull, a West African cautionary story. And that's the end of that.